Dudes in the hood will talk to these younger women because they know that the older woman, they get smart. You know what I'm saying? They get smart. They don't want a waste man. Older women don't want a waste man. They don't want a dude that you out here like you thinking it's cool. Like you think gang banging is the shit. Like you don't got no credit. You don't got no job. You living off your baby moms. You staying from this couch to that bed to this bed. You a grown ass man. Older woman, they see the bum shit. The little girls, they might be like, oh, that's cool, that's cute, and this and that and the third. Back to the point I was saying, these women see the low life in you. You know what I'm saying? So you go to the younger girls, and this is like the cycle. This is the cycle in the hood. The cycle in the hood is these older dudes be kicking game to these younger girls that don't know better. You know what I'm saying? Like, it's just sad, man. This shit is just sad. All this shit is just sad, man. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, and I understand, like, we living in this, you know, it's crazy. You know how many of my friends in the hood do not have credit cards? Do you know how many people in the hood do not have, like, their credit score? Like, they don't even have debit cards. Like, the people in the hood, when it comes to finances, when it comes to, like, a whole bunch of stuff, they just oblivious. They just oblivious. So I kind of get it. But then it's like, damn. It's like, damn, where are we going to evolve? At what point are we going to evolve? And I get it, it's systematic oppression. And you know, they got us fighting each other. They pack us up like sardines in the hood. And I, you know, I'm gonna sound like it's a lot of, you know, I got a lot of videos where I talk about a lot of this stuff, and I get it. I get how the system has constructed the ghettos and has placed us there and got us fighting each other. I get that. But at what point do we become accountable? I'm saying, at what point do we become accountable for ourselves and the stuff that we've done? At what point? It's like I was telling somebody the other day, like, we be sitting here, we frown upon rape, right? When somebody rapes somebody, we frown upon rape. We be like, oh my God, we don't fuck with rapists. But if your mans go kill somebody, if your mans go kill somebody for some stupid shit, you gonna sit there and be like, free my mans. Like, what are we doing? What are we doing? What's good? How you say free? Me and my mans got into this argument. I say, yo, black lives only matter when the police does the killing. That's the only time it matters, when the police does the killing. Because any other time, dudes be sitting here killing each other. You know what I'm saying? And I get it. I get it. Shit happens. Should be too deep. What's up? What's up? What's up? Should be too deep. I get it. But we be sitting here killing each other. You know what I'm saying? And then we want to be saying, yo, free Tyrone, free Boogie, free Jay, free Day Day, free this person. And you know he did some senseless shit. You know he did some stupid shit. You know he went out there, shot a little boy. He shot up the park, killed the little boy. You know what I'm saying? He killed the old woman. He killed the mother. He killed whoever he killed. And y'all sitting out here talking about free him. What do I look like? What do I look like saying free my mans that did a senseless killing? That shit is dumb. What I look like sitting here? That means I condone that shit. That means borderline, I'm okay with the fact that he took a soul unjustly. Now, if you're defending yourself, I get it. I get it. You know what I'm saying? Because it's the oppression. You know what I'm saying? It's slavery was about enslaving the minds. It's not about the physical things that they did to us. The physical things were just a ritual to enslave our minds. So we slaves. We walking up, we running around here like slaves. We programmed. We hypnotized. That's why it's so easy for us to look at each other like enemies, right? Because they turned us against each other since from the plantation. You understand what I'm saying? But I don't use that excuse because it's the truth. But at the same time, after slavery, we was doing things. After slavery, when you think about the Black Panther Party, when you think about like the NOI, when you think about certain groups, we was actually doing things. We actually built. You know, we actually was getting degrees. We actually had middle class black suburbs. We actually had wealth. We actually had wealth. Like, we actually was doing things. You know, black people lived better during segregation than now. Black people were doing better during segregation, Jim Crow, than they are now. You understand what I'm saying? So when people try to sit here and say like, when people try to sit here and say like, oh, it's Willie Lynch. Oh, Willie Lynch is another form of psychological mind fuck. Because they sat here and tell us that this man, the so-called prophet, prophesized that we will be fighting each other, that we will get turned against each other, and we will be fighting each other for thousands of years. But guess what? Guess what? At the end of the day, we had successful moments in history. So what happened? We gotta really go back in history and be like, what happened. Like we want to, you know what I'm saying? We gotta go back, because we can't just say Willie Lynch today, but then what happened in the 60s? What happened in the 40s? What happened in the 30s when black people were actually doing this? What was happening? Because so Willie Lynch syndrome skipped like a few decades, and then you know what I'm saying? No. What happened was they kept attacking us. They sent HIV, they sent crack cocaine, they did a little more divide and conquer. They started getting our own people to snitch on other people. You know, they started doing all these different tactics. This is all the different things that they did. All these different things that they did. They just constantly kept attacking us. Constantly. This is what they do. Today, they do the same thing. We can't do nothing today because they got all these different movements. They got the woman movement. They got the LGBT. They got the this. They got the that. They got so many things that are distracting us. The miseducation in school. They distracting us. They distracting us. They attacking us in so many different ways. They putting shit in our food. They building our apartments a certain way with certain materials that are harmful for us, that makes us not really understand certain things that affect our brain in a certain way. The music, who controls our music? Who control all our music? Huh? Facts. They made us hate ourselves and love their wealth. Who control our music? They control our music. We don't even own BET. No. Yo, we don't own nothing. We don't even own do-rags. You know, black people created the do-rag. Black people created the do-rag, and we don't have no rights to it. We don't control it. We don't manufacture it. We don't make it. But who wear most of the do-rags? Us. And we don't even control who makes this. It's crazy. We don't own nothing. We don't own nothing. You feel me? We don't own nothing. You know what I'm saying? So I went in a little rant, but like I just feel like I get it. I get all the issues, and I get why we are our own enemy.